As part of the exhibition program, a series of video interviews with the artists are published online. The interview questions have been prepared by the students at the photography program at the University of Gothenburg. In this first film, Mathieu Asselin and Sergio Valenzuela Escobedo share their thoughts on the exhibition format and the publication as organic, flexible productions. The specific work that they focus on in this interview is Asselin's large-scale project, Monsanto, a Photographic Investigation, which we can see a part of here behind me. The work is an examination of the multinational biotechnology company Monsanto, and Mathieu Asselin's focus is on the contamination and the devastating effect on life and nature resulting from the company's actions.
Since 2017, we have worked together. Me, as you may know, I'm a documentary photographer. I'm interested on long-term documentary projects. It's socially critical. The way I work, we can tell it is a research-based documentary photography. My last work, and I think the work is going to be exhibited at the Hasselblad Foundation, is Monsanto, a Photographic Investigation. 5 years research, production, work on the multinational Monsanto. We get invited to the Rencontre d'Arles, and I didn't know what to do. And you know, I kind of know with the help of Ricardo how to put a book together, but an exhibition was completely new for me. And I didn't really knew where to start. And this is where Sergio joined the project. Sergio had already experience as a curator, and so it was, I think it was the perfect match.
I think that curator need to take care. It's at least to me, you have like a definition of curating. And in this specific situation where we come out with this idea of an organic exhibition, which is every space, every place we are gonna go, we're gonna just think about what is happening there, what's the relationship with Monsanto, and what's the project needs to be tell about the situation.
The publication of the book, it has become, as the exhibition, something organic and something that needs to fit the needs of the project. The publication by Actus Sud of the book, book that it is a beautiful object, a quite expensive object as well, and an object that fulfilled its task when it was needed. So at that time, it was important to have this beautiful book, this beautiful object. But as the project evolved in many ways, but as the project became an exhibition, as the project is become an educational tool, as the project moves on, the publication needed to change as well. And this is why we did, for example, the newsprint. We have printed almost 10,000 copies. This newsprint, of course, is free to download in my webpage. So as you see, we didn't stop on the book. We say like, okay, the book is sold out, the book is very expensive, what can we do? So let's do a newsprint that is a resume of the exhibition designed. The newsprint is designed by Ricardo Valles, and it's a beautiful object too, but in a cheaper way. So the motivations for this project is I think it's very simple. It is outrage, really. When I understood what Monsanto is and what they were doing as a citizen, maybe an engaged citizen, I wanted to say something. And it's the need of a channel this outrage in a coherent way. You know, everything started with a conversation I had with my father. He went to New York. I used to live in New York in that time. And he went to New York to visit me, and he told me about Monsanto. And you know, right away I was like, wow, who is these people? Why these people do what they do? And you know, and And I started looking into the story, and I realized that actually not only the story was huge, and not only what my father told me was the tip of the iceberg, but that the story hasn't been told as a whole story.
Photographically
speaking, yes. It's been the story, photographically speaking, it's been told in small pieces. Agent Orange, the problem with the farmers, the contaminations of PCB. So, but I thought that it would be interesting to put everything together in one story. And I think we cannot understand Monsanto if we don't link all these stories together. So the next question and the last question is about advice. What is the advice we give to new photographers, upcoming photographers, students that are in this photography world?
To me, at least, it's about the passion, and I think that's something very important when you decide to you talk about your feeling, how you are against this Monsanto company. This is what, to me, it's the most difficult part of a photographic project. It's easy to go and look for histories, but how do you feel about it?
For stories, yeah.
For history, yeah. Where's your heart in that project? By then, this is the passion that you have with it.
Yeah, this is a long conversation, and we're not giving it for free. No, I'm kidding. No, but it's true. I think it's very important to really understand where you're embarking in. Mm. And research can help a lot on that. Most of the time when you work in this type of critical, engaged, social work, is also how the work can be a part of something larger than the project itself. I think what is important is how you will inscribe, how you will make this project as a part of something larger than the project itself.
Yeah.